So thank you very much for your very kind introduction, and thanks people for coming. As Chairman explained, my main work is in nano imaging based on near field optics and plasmonics. So this topic is an quite old research of mine, but probably due to the recent advances in 3D printing, you kindly remember me again to talk these topics. And how can I move on the screen? So the title is 3D nano-fabrication drawing or growing, and I'm going to talk about drawing method first, which is a bit old topics, and I will show a little bit new work on self-growing method. Yes. So I invented a 3D microfabrication using the two-photon absorbed photopolymerization nearly 20 years ago. I show, no, this is moving. So, yes, we draw the spiral structure in 3D using the laser beam many years ago. The motivation of mine to do this research was that I was not much satisfied. I was a bit frustrated by the 2D nanotechnology. Everybody fabricated the structures on the surface of the film in 2D, like these examples. But if you use a light, why not 3D? Light penetrate your materials so that you can make the 3D nanotechnology. But people used a UV, deep UV, which is absorbed by the materials. So it was not 3D recording 3D fabrication like E-beam or a focused ion beam. But if you use a near infrared light, this can penetrate through your medium. But it means that there is no interaction with the light and the materials. It's just a penetration. However, if you have a femtosecond laser with a high peak power, and if you have a highly tighted objective lens, you have a possibility of a two-photon absorption, and only the position of the focus, you can have an interaction by two-photon. In this case, a photo polymerizable resin with a photo monomer and oligomers. And then by moving the laser beam, you can draw the structure in 3D. So this was my proposal many years ago, and we have drawn a structure like this animal. The size was like an 8 micron long and 5 micron high, with an 50 nanometer step in every step in X and Y and Z, with a near-infrared femtosecond laser. And the total time of the exposure was in 30 minutes. Still, this is one of the most precise fine structures, I believe. And the method was simple. We just used a galvanometer mirror set to move the beam in the resin, and along Z, we move the stage. Actually, we draw the structure in this. In this region, and the size was not small here, but it was demagnified by 100 times in the resin. And in the paper, I have compared two results. One is here, and the other is the left one. And the right one, middle one, shows a sharper, clear structure. The difference is that to record this one, we draw the laser beam at every voxels of the this animal, while this one was made by drawing only the surface, skin of the animal. And we extract the unpolymerized resin outside the animal, and we gave a shot to polymerize inside. So the result was much shorter time of the exposure and much finer without any diffusion of the polymerized voxels. And this is in the same image of a human hair, actually hair of my student who made this bull. So the size is much smaller than the size of the diameter of the human hairs. So in the paper, I have mentioned that this kind of method can be used for producing micro machines working inside the human body. Actually, we didn't do it much, but we have proposed, and we show just one preliminary experiment. We made this in a micro spring. Outer diameter is in a 2 micron, but this is an optical microscope image. Previous one was image taken by a scanning electron microscope. The structure is too fine, so even though you draw the structure by laser beam, you can't see the fine structure. So in this case, you don't see the fine detail. This is an optical microscope image, but you can see the movement. And we measure the spring constant of this fine spring, and compared with a spring with a thicker one. Actually, we held this bead and moved this in a cube and to see the motion. And actually, this was done by the laser trapping. We trapped this one and we moved the stage. And then not only this spring, but also bead and the cube were also made by two-photon process. And the resolution, I mean, the size, minimum size is about 120 nanometer, which is because not only by the two-photon nonlinear process, but also thresholding effect of the radical quenching in polymerization. The size is in a, like in a 120, but by positively utilizing the shrinkage effect of the polymerization, we could have make it thinner down to 65 nanometer. And this one. So this is in a 1.4 micron above the substrate. So this is in 3D. And then you can draw, you can write many kind of patterns as you like, including this kind of crystal structures. And many people have done them. But this kind can be done by multi-beam interferometric technology. So this is not too much fun to me. And the more interesting structure is like a more complicated structure, like an array of the spiral antenna. And this was done by with a microlens array. And if you can draw the structure in 3D, you can draw, you can write data, bit data in even the optical disks. And this is also no new work. And that moment, optical disk was very well used, while the recording layer was only recording was made only in one layer. And that moment, the depth, thickness of the recording layer is like 50 to 100 nanometer, while the thickness is, sorry, not nanometer, 1.2 millimeter. So I complained that only 0.04 point was used for recording, otherwise nothing. So why not recording the data in 3D? It is an, based on the concept of multi-layer disks, which is somehow now commercially available. And we have shown that we could record. Sorry. we recorded 26 bit data from A to Z with every 5 micron, and this is not only recording but also erasable, rewritable, and we read it by the confocal. The material was a photoisomer, and we tried it with a two-photon process. It is an, has an, two isomer stages. In isomer A, this is this doesn't work well. Here, isomer A, there's no absorption invisible, but if you give an UV light, it moves to the isomer B, which has an absorption visible, and then giving the 532, it goes back to the isomer A. So this is a photochromic material, molecule, doped in PMMA. But we used a two photon, so we gave a near-infrared light to change the isomers from A to B, B to A. And the reading was done by 532, which is not the range of absorption, so that you can read as many times as you like. But our interest is more to move to fabricating metallic materials, because metallic nanostructures is very much interesting by showing the exotic optical properties like negative refraction or cloaking. But the structure is metallic and 3D and large scale, while having the very fine sub-wavelength structures. So it's not easy to make it. But anyway, we have metallized the structure by coating the metal onto the photopolymer to the 3D structures. But this is a silver, but only the outside is silver, inside is still polymer. So we wanted to make the real full metal structures in 3D, in nano. So we tried to, if two-photon photoreduction is possible or not. And actually, it was possible. We have drawn three-dimensional, in this case, bipyramid structure in solution. So the, inside the solution, you have silver ions, and then you give a laser beam and scan the beam, I mean, draw the beam in the solution, and then silver ions is reduced to the silver, and then show this kind of 3D structures on the substrate. So, and the resolution was like an 18 nanometer, and the conductivity is three times worse than that of the silver, bulk silver. The next is in the self-growing. When I did the two-photon polymerization, I have found that the growing of the fiber structure in resin by focused beam without moving the beam spot focus. But in this case, we use a UV light which polymerizes directly the monomers and oligomers. So we given a stationary focused laser beam and choosing the optical parameters, optimal parameters, we see the fiber is growing as long as 1 millimeter diameter. This particular case was 3 micron. It depends on the parameters. So without moving the laser beam, we see the polymer fiber is grown, and the length is proportional to the exposure time from this case, 0 second to 1.3 seconds. So this is a simple experiment, but it's fun to see. And the mechanism can be explained as follows. You have a focused beam of the UV laser which polymerize, solidify the resin, giving the higher refractive index at the position of the focus. So this small volume of the high index particle works as a convex lens. And the convex lens focuses the laser beam, produces a light spot in front. And then again, the polymerization occurs. And then the light spot is, polymerization continues, and the spot is focusing always at the head of the structure. And then through the waveguide mode, the light propagates in this structure and giving the light spot at the top. As a result, you have an optical fiber inside. So this mechanism is different, but this can be expressed by the same mathematics as the nonlinear Schrödinger equation observed in the color medium. If so, we can, this is an simulation and with parameters which you used in the experiment. We see the fiber is growing and the laser beam is focusing like in a self spatial soliton case. So this is seen in nature like the generation, formation of river. Once channel is made, it's fixed and water digs the river. But at the mountain area, you have many rivers merging into one. Near the ocean or lake, river branches into many. So we wanted to check if this can be seen in our optical fiber formulation. And yes, we can see it by optimizing the parameter. You can have a branching of the fibers. It doesn't become the thick one cone. It becomes many of fibers due to the some inhomogeneity at the end of the forced sphere. So as a result, always it becomes a fiber with the same width, and depending on the parameters, the number of the fibers or angles or others are different. And the merging can be also seen if you have two laser beams. These fibers are grown and it goes to merges into one fiber always. So we wanted to see the similar effect in metal, and we wanted to make a silver forest. Forest is made of the branches with leaves, and this is formed as follows. First, you have a seeds on the field, seeds of the trees on the field, and you give the rains and light, sunlight, then the trees are grown from the seeds. Only the area where the sunlight illuminated. As a result, you have a forest. So similarly, I wanted to do this with a silver. And on the substrate, we have a nano silver seeds of a few nanometers in diameters, and you have a solution, acetone water solution of silver ions and ascorbic acids. And then if you give a light, which matches to the resonance of the silver nanoparticle, plasmon resonance, which is 355, you have a heating up effect onto this seed, which triggers the growth of the silver crystal. And then the ions are consumed to reduce silver needle. Then there is an gradient in the silver ions, so that the silver ions are coming to the tree. And we don't use a surfactant, so there's an inhomogeneity to produce the crystal, and there are many protrusions on the side of the silver needle, from where you have another growth of the silver needle, and again sub-branches and sub-sub-branches. As a result, you have a forest. This is a same image of an 1 by 1 millimeter. It is patterned by the UV light as a letter tree in Chinese, where silvers are grown, trees are grown. So outside no trees, inside the light illumination area, you have a silver trees grown, and this is a magnified, 300 times magnified image of this red square area, and you have a small fine structures, and another enlargement shows the trees with the leaves. And we have estimated, evaluated the dimensions, fractal dimensions. This is a fractals, and it is four generations of fractals, and the dimension is like an, 1.7 or 1.8, which is quite high. The fractal dimension of coastal line is typically like 1.2 or 1.3 in nature. So this is quite high dimension of fractal. And we have measured the spectra, extension spectral response of this dendrites. And this is a spectra of nanoseed. At less than 400, you have a resonance due to the plasmons, while this tree has a quite broad spectral response. And it can be decomposed into several components of this rods with the same width but in a different length. So this one is decomposed into four. So this represents this structure on this side. And this is the same image on the right, upper part of the right, and the lower part of the right part. It's an diffractogram, which represents the FCC crystal structure. It shows an hexagonal. And we have examined that this structure can be used for the substrate of the SARS spectroscopy. This one is the left above shows an same image of the structure tree. Inside this star structure has many trees. Outside is nothing, no trees. And the inside, and the, we disperse the rhodamine 6G molecules, and the inside you can have, this is on the right, upper right, you have a spectrum, which is a Raman spectrum from the red circle part, and you see the Raman signal, which was much enhanced by nanotrees, while the lower part on the right shows the spectrum, but it does Raman spectrum, but actually you don't see any Raman signal. You see the scale is much, intensity is much larger. It shows mostly fluorescence. And the lower left part shows a fluorescence optical microscope image. So you don't see the enhancement of the Raman by outside the letters tree, but you see the fluorescence, because metal works not only for enhancing the Raman scattering, but also working for quenching the fluorescence. So this is a summary of talk. I have talked about two approaches, top-down and bottom-up. In top-down, you can do 3D direct drawing, or you can do layer-by-layer drawing, printing. And not only polymerization, but also reduction and some others can be used by two-photon process. The resolution is limited by, depending on the method, but typically 25 to 100 nanometer. The limitation is if this is nano, the fabrication size becomes small and it takes quite a long time to make a large size. And the self-growing method, we have shown that fibers is grown from polymerizable resin, and we also show the growth of the metallic nanostructures, which has a fractal geometry with a self-similarity. And we didn't do, this is still ongoing research project. And in theory, you can predict, expect the negative refraction from this 3D bulk materials, but we haven't checked it yet. And this can be made in large scale easily in 3D, but the shape which you can make is not orbital really, but limited in the crystal geometry. So I think this is the end of my talk. So I'd like to thank my students and colleagues to do this research work. So thank you very much for your kind attention.